dancing the rumba, the cha-cha, salsa, and the jive, which we call it the boogie in Manila.
We're on that road along the way. The problem now, of course, is to simply hold your horses. To rush would be a crime, because nice and easy does it. One more time, like the chairman of the board says. Nice and easy does it. Nice and easy does it. Nice and easy does it every time. Thank you.
West Lake Shopping Center. Is that what it was? Hey, Michael, was that really you? You're kidding me, are you?
More smooth.
Nothing. I part.
Thank you.
bansang Pilipinas, kaya marami ho tayong kailangan ipagmalaki. So our next part, we have the Kalikasan Dance Company. Sila yung isang non-profit organization sa Union City.
Like a small Samoan. Actually, my father is white, my mother is Filipina. I'm a flip-flop. I'm a mistake-o. See, my father is white, I'm dark. Alam mo nangyari dito, pinaglay ako sa puto. Nung susubo ng nanay ko, nahulog sa dinuguan. Malas ko lang, Diyos ko. Look at all these, look at all the Filipino people over here. My God, Jesus Christ, there's nobody in Saramonte right now, huh? You're gonna get robbed. Daly City, I like Daly City. Daly City is a beautiful place. When I first came to America, I walked up to a white girl and I go like this, excuse me, can you please give me sex? I have no money, but I buy you a bucket of chicken. Extra wings. But I'm having a lot of fun over here. Let me get this microphone over here. Jesus Christ, where? How many, before I do that, how many Ilocano we got here tonight? Ilocano, raise your hands. Good, spend your money, God damn it. Something happened here. No, let me put this over here. Hey, isn't she beautiful, ladies and gentlemen? If I had a wife like that, I wouldn't even have sex anymore. I'll just do it alone in the front of the mirror. Ano siya natin dito?
Wala, ilalagay natin kita. Isusubong na kita sa FCC.
FCC for what? Filipino come here, Filipino come there. I don't know anymore.
Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you. See, she takes care of me. She should be my wife, but she's married. I don't care anymore.
I have two kids.
She's got two kids. That's funny. I got two lovers. And they're like this. So anyway, as I was saying, you know, being a Filipino is so nice to be a Filipino. Oh, look at that. That's my friend over there shaking at me. He's one. No, wala na naman, just go. No, Filipinos, Filipinos are proud people. We're proud. You gotta be proud to be a Filipino. Come on, give it up. Filipinos, we have a lot of pride. We have a lot of pride. We got fried chicken. Fried lumpia, fried adobo. We got everything. Did anybody here see the movie here, E.T.? Remember E.T.? The little son, E.T.? Did you know that E.T. is Filipino? I'm serious. Did you hear an all Ilocano man count? 81, 82, 83, 86, 87, 88, 90. Hey, you know, it's cool. Well, okay. How many people here dance to the Macarena? Macarena? Every time you go to a Filipino party, this Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. Do you know that Macarena is Kapampangan? Puto nagdamo ko ni Macarena. How many Kapampangan we got here tonight? Kapampangan, yay! Kapampangan are cool. Kapampangan, dude, oh man, they're the coolest people in the world. Oh, cool, Kapampangan. They wear nice clothes, nice shoes, nice hair, nice everything, but they only got 10 cents in their pocket. It's true, huh? And if you ever notice here in America, if you listen to some of the Soul Brothers, not all the Soul Brothers, but some of the Soul Brothers, when they talk, you ever notice they sound like a bambanga? Soul Brother be going, say, man, what's wrong with you, sucker? Man, you be talking to me? Shit, I don't know what just who I already have that sense. Well, that's true, though. You know, I have so much fun over here. How many people here like Elvis Presley? The Did you know that Elvis Presley is not dead? He came back. He's a Filipino now. He's here somewhere. He's over there somewhere, maybe in Safeway. You know, here in America, we got the best of everything, you know? You kids over here, look at these kids. Look at that. They got everything. They got Nike. They got what? Reebok. In the Philippines, we had Pa. Paaki. Reebaki. And then we go to the market, we step on the kakaputan bato. Mommy? Yeah, the kids here, all of you kids here, we grew up with the best of everything. The kids here in America, we grew up with kids like John, Hank, Willie, Joe, and Harry. In the Philippines, we got it bad. We grew up with kids like Buk Buk, Bet, Pikit, Boy Tulog, and Tony Taklahan. They named the kids after their handicap, like Boy Bahogang. How come they call you Boy Bahogang? You put down your hand, you put down your hand, you put down your hand. So one day, I was in the Philippines in Angeles City, next to Malabanas, Malango. You know Malango? Malango is the land of the flies. We got more kabambang at the flies over there, kabambang. So Elvis Presley just showed up, and Elvis Presley was in the town. I said, excuse me, Mr. Elvis Presley, is that you? He says, yeah, I'm Elvis, and I'm going to sing a song. I feel good. I feel good out here in Malango. Malabanas. Angeles City. Like Mr. Elvis, today is Tony Takla's birthday. Could you please sing a song for Tony Takla, please, Elvis? Just one song. Elvis says, well, I'm in a hurry, but excuse me for a minute. He stepped at the thing, too. So I said, Mr. Elvis, please a song for Mr. Tony Takla. He says, okay, I'll do that. I'll do that for you, baby. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, Takla. But before I get out of here, ladies and gentlemen, I got a pressing engagement. I'm going to the bathroom after the show. And if you want to buy tickets, please, get it. I want to do my impersonation, ladies and gentlemen, of the first Filipino football player interviewed by Howard Cosell about 30 years ago. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Howard Cosell. Tonight on Wide World of Sports, we'll be talking to the first Filipino football player. His name is Buk Buk Johnson. He's half breed. He's a mistake-o. Statistic: height 4'11". Weight 98 pounds. Position, running back. A great knack for talent and a great talent for not coming back. Ladies and gentlemen, due to the game with the gridiron last week, Buk Buk Johnson was diminished into a triple amputee, and he doesn't look good. Let's talk to Buk Buk Johnson and ask him what happened out there. Why did he lose his legs, his arm, and something else? Buk Buk Johnson, look at you. What happened out there? What happened?
I told the quarterback, do not pass me the goddamn ball. But he passed me the ball. And then I saw these two big black guys. They come to me. They spin my knees like this. And they said, make a wish, sucker. I don't feel good now, thank you. And it's been a night.
Mamay na kahit ako ay isang pangkaraniwang nilalang.
Small bones. This maroon and green evening gown are made of taffeta and polyester. The bodice top fabric is polyester with some design prints. Decorated with beads. And the train is decorated with lace. Designer idea for this long gold evening gold gown is to showcase a part of the body that is also a fashion statement. The bodice top of this evening gown is made of brocade. The skirt, the designer creatively uses flowers, a perfume box, and wires to assemble the headpiece. Definitely for a Parisian runway. It is windy. This orange evening gown is made of 100% taffeta, and the drape is made of 100% polyester. The back waistline is decorated with flowers using the same fabric. Here's a special one coming up. Filipino national costume name, Maria Clara. The skirt is made of satin and cuts in pieces individually and sewn back together. And the bodice is decorated with different lace. This dress was the winner of the best Filipino national costume at last week's Filipino Fiesta, which was held at Pier 45. Worn by Gene Henson, of course. Thank our models, Amy, Fatima, Erica, Sierra, and Bronson. Let's give them a big hand for being here. And of course, the fashion designer, Miss Jean Henson.
That's all right, some do lie, but there's I believe your sunrise to worship me. Only drag me in the ride.